I second that. Thank you very much, A&L Creations. This is a wonderful addition to the event. So now it's time to move into our chemical census.
Wait, Andy, should I be worried? Are things going to be blown up? What's going on?
Lauren, before you run to get your hazmat suit, the chemical senses are just senses that are based on the reception of chemicals. So, for example, your sense of smell or your sense of taste.
Oh, so with smell, the tiny particles that go up your nose and that are detected by your smell receptors?
Exactly, and something pretty similar for taste, actually. Let's actually go to Susan, who is, sounds like she's on location at the taste-off now.
Thank you, Andy. Although the taste-off will focus on our sense-leads' ability to activate their 10,000 taste buds, the person who's going to excel in this competition is the one who also activates their smell receptors.
It's truly amazing how our perception of taste actually depends on the sensation of taste and smell.
It really is. How is it possible that these two seemingly different senses are so intimately related?
Well, Andy, that's because both taste and smell are processed up here in the frontal lobes of our brain. For the taste-off, the contestants are going to have to identify samples that contain each of the five basic flavors. These are sweet, salty, sour, savory, and bitter. To do this, we'll be using the following ingredients: sugar, salt, lemon, MSG, and tonic water.
And Susan, which ingredient is going to correspond to which flavor?